Over the last 10 years, it has been clear that repressive governments recognise that human rights defenders are key agents of change. It is why they have invested so much time and energy and brutality in seeking to defame, marginalise, undermine, threaten, restrict, control and eliminate them. Indeed, human rights defender Farai Magugu from Zimbabwe was detained without charge at Harare last weekend by unidentified security agents as he attempted to join us at the platform. His belongings and flight tickets were confiscated, and he was chased from the airport by the security agents. But the good news is that he is here. Over the last 10 years, the brutality, the torture, and the killings have not decreased. So today we honour all human rights defenders who have been killed. Floribert Tadjibaeva, director of Voix des Enfants, was one of the human rights defenders we were in contact with from the earliest years. He participated in our first Dublin platform. We met on and off, and he was always ready to help us with assistance for other human rights defenders in Congo. His brutal murder in June last year was a devastating blow. The brazen killing of one of the most respected and well-connected human rights defenders in Africa sent a message that no human rights defender was safe. We set out in Frontline 10 years ago with enthusiasm, excitement, and the unspoken promise of individual commitment. At the core of our work was the thought of all you brave defenders and your relentless work for the human rights of other people. In the last year, the Arab uprisings have unleashed a wind of change that has rattled tyrants, not only in the Middle East, but around the world. In Tunisia, Egypt, Libya, Yemen, Bahrain, and Syria, threats and brutality have failed to quell the movement for freedom and human rights, and human rights defenders have played a key role. They will continue to play a key role, monitoring reprisals, documenting atrocities on all sides, demanding justice for the victims, advocating for just constitutions in accordance with international standards. Dear human rights defenders, many times you have been beset with private agonies, so full of horror that you feel you cannot take any more. When despair calls out and beckons you in. Yet you refuse, you endure, and you continue to spread light and life into darkness and create hope for those who must never lose hope. You are our partners in the front line, and we pledge to be your shadows, trying to protect you and support you in your struggle. Tadjibaeva from Uzbekistan was invited to the 2005 Dublin platform. Unfortunately, Mutabar was arrested on her way to the airport to come to the Dublin platform. And that following March, she was sentenced to 8 years in prison. Her prison conditions were horrific. So we decided on her birthday that we would try and send her some flowers for her birthday. Now, we really didn't think that the flowers would arrive. We weren't sure whether we could find, first of all, a flower agent who was willing to deliver the flowers to the prison, and then the chances of them being delivered to Mutabar, we thought, would be very slim. But we were so lucky because there was a sympathetic prison official, and he gave the flowers to Mutabar on her birthday. And we were so happy because it meant for us, it meant that she knew she wasn't forgotten about. So Mutabar has been a long time coming to the Dublin platform. She was released finally in 2008. And we are so happy now to welcome her after 6 years to the 6th Dublin platform.